We know it's 16 feet long. It ended up being 32 inches tall. It's going to hold an aquarium that will hold 1,077 gallons. It is by far the easiest and cheapest and even the largest aquarium stand that I've built. And before I show you how to build it, I want to show you, well, the little mock-up that we did first. This is simply one of the 4-foot-long 60-gallon tanks. A mock-up being, this is the type of wood we're going to use, which is Malaysian bogwood, as well as the plants that I want to add to this big aquarium. Yes, the 16-footer is definitely, I definitely feel that it's gotta go planted as we can make it. But I wanna make sure that the plants can live in my water and under my conditions before I commit on this scale, 19 times bigger than this scale. Now, obviously the layout's not going to match. It's not going to be identical. Again, I'm just using the same materials, Malaysian bogwood, these types of plants in that tank. The stocking for now, and we already have them, is a super white black diamond stingray, geophagus, as well as Ultum angelfish. There's going to be an array of other fish being added, but those were the ones that we secured immediately. I started off by adding in some humate substrate. This is just different brands of aqua soil. Technically, it's all leftover stuff that I already had, and I knew I was only gonna need about 2 to 3 inches of it. I brought most of it to the front because I knew that's where the plants were going to go, and again, this is just a test tank. Eventually, I'm going to transfer a lot of this wood over to the other tank, simply because it's got all this moss on it. The first plant we added in was the Brazilian micro sword. I've never used this plant before, so I don't know if it's going to grow in this tank. But I love to buy tissue cultured portions because it comes free of algae, any types of pests like snails, etc. It gives me a really fresh start. The next one we know grows for a fact out in my water. Dwarf sedge. How well does it grow? Well, when's the last time you've seen an aquarium simply using 5 3-foot long shop lights on a 700 gallon aquarium, no CO2, no nothing else, and it looks like this. Did I get lucky with this? I'm not sure, but this is dwarf sedge all along here. It grows to different sizes. It can be like this. It can grow up as tall as this stuff, and this is probably about 4, 5, 6 inches. There might even be some longer pieces. It all comes down to how much light is it getting and how much flow, but I would say more importantly, how much lighting. You'll notice that the longer pieces are further away from the light, almost as if they're stretching up. But this, I know, grows, and it grows really, really well. I should probably state, many say you can't do carpeting plants with CO2, and I'll admit that the best results I ever got were using CO2 when I was trying to grow carpet plants, like when we did the discus tank and we had all dwarf hair grass, or when we did the rainbow fish tank, the 375 gallon rainbow fish tank, and we had nothing but moss. That grew in like it did, simply due not only to a combination of the lights, but CO2. I'm finding CO2 injection being slightly more important, but it all depends on the system, and that's what I'm trying to test here. So the next plant that I wanted to add, and I've always liked the look of it, I like it because it's like a very bright green, was Monte Carlo. I've never touched it, never tried it. I even think it will grow on wood, so maybe that's something we'll try. Somebody in the comments let me know, or I could just Google it, but I'd rather you guys tell me. Will Monte Carlo only grow in soil, or will it grow on items like wood as well? Probably not rock, but maybe wood. I'm not sure, but I'd like to see if I can get it to carpet in here. So those are the three main plants that I'm thinking of adding to the base of the aquarium. Maybe I'll get some dwarf hair grass as well, but that's definitely gonna require CO2. Right now, I'm running this without CO2, just to see what happens. And I'm gonna give it 30 days, and by 30 days is up, I should have this tank ready to start my scaping and or at least ordering the plants. Finally, and it doesn't look like it, but we added in weeping moss. What? No, you didn't. I added in spiky moss. Spiky moss is gonna grow much differently than weeping moss. I think that when I ordered this, I wanted weeping, but I grabbed the spiky because that's what was in stock. Spiky moss grows differently than weeping moss, but we cover this. Moving forward, every time I see weeping moss, please don't cringe. I'm going to. one of my favorite mosses, and under the right conditions, and this is a big thing when you're working with mosses, is that if you're going to get the characteristics that it's being sold as, whether it's Christmas moss, flame moss, weeping moss, they all kind of grow differently. And it largely depends on the type of light you're using, as well as if it's CO2 injected. Even moss, which doesn't need much, will grow much better with CO2. Right now, it just kind of looks like tufts of fake moss, but it's real. We just need to give it some time to get established, and I just glued that right onto the wood because the moss needs absolutely nothing. Now, believe it or not, with shipping, that's about $200 worth of plants. And the reason why I wanted to do a mock-up is for simple reasons. Once I discovered that this works, I could take some of these plants out and use it, but the new tank is going to be 19 times bigger, which means that if I want to have that same immediate effect of that many plants in it all at once, it's going to cost almost $4,000 worth of plants. Luckily, I have the wood. I'm not so sure if we will go with a lot of plants on the base. Again, maybe I'll just do portions. One of the things I was thinking is maybe a huge island in one of the viewing panels of wood, moss, kind of like that, but really big wood. Ugh. I mean, really big wood. Yeah, this piece is 42 inches long, and once I stand it up, about 21 inches tall. I have a few pieces like that. I can connect them together. I can add in the smaller the smaller pieces of wood simply because they are identical sourced and similar in texture. I can make it look like one continuous piece. One of the things I was thinking was I make two islands, boom, boom. This one's covered in moss, and then just around it is planted. And the same with the other one, and then the rest is just like a white sand. Stingray could be an issue eventually, but I say we might as well give it a shot. If I do it that way, we cut costs. Oh geez, what would that even cut it by? Maybe in four, cut it in four instead of four, almost 4,000, be maybe $800, something like that. Worth a shot, worth an idea. Thought I'd run that one by you. Now with this tank, I'm not necessarily in love with the scape, obviously, because it's massive pieces of wood, but it is actually really cool. And one of the things I was thinking is, uh-oh, what if this does work out really good? What if all of this grows in so nicely that I don't want to rip it apart? Okay, just buy extra plants and you already got tons of wood. We can just keep it like this. I'm already trying to sink some wood down here because this is going to be planted, and then the bottom tank is going to be a breeding tank, all of which is connected by a common filter for now. I'll show you how I did that in the future, but I'm definitely going to be building a sump for this, and I'll show you guys how to connect all of your tanks with one filter here in the near future. But so far, I planted these, I think it was 3 days ago. I'm not seeing anything dead, but I'm not seeing any growth, which is common. And totally fine. But isn't this wood, piece of wood right here, just one of the coolest Malaysian bogwoods you've ever seen? Like, fish could swim through it, all around it. It's just incredible. The camera does not pick up. Oh, you want to see something really cool about this setup? Is I can come back here now and look at everything and see how everybody's doing, how everything's going. Yes, very cool. I can't wait for these setups. A lot of people are saying, oh, give them 30 days. No, I got plans. You know, maybe one day this will be gone. Maybe one day this will be gone. This is going to be a permanent structure, so I gotta take it dead serious. Permanent structure. These tanks are just too big to move. I mean, the Piranha Aquarium, 700 gallons. Maybe one day these tanks will move. I have big plans for next year, so eventually maybe we'll just have this guy, and that guy out there for personal aquariums, because I'm not going to be able to handle everything that I have coming up and planned in terms of aquariums and areas. Oh, and on the topic of the 2000, oh, I'll save that for last. You guys really going to be excited about that. So the 16-foot stand was easy to build. We've got it sitting on 38 concrete blocks. And mind you, it's not done being painted. I only painted the front of the blocks. I'm going to paint the sides as well. truth be told, I just got lazy and I hate painting, so I did a little bit and I was like, okay, that's enough, I can make the video now. Each block is 16 inches long, 8 inches wide, 8 inches tall. Three of them, 8, 16, 24. And then we have a 2x10, which adds another 10 inches, and 3/8 plywood on top of that. Anyways, blocks are dry. We can begin building the rest of the stand, getting it painted, and essentially ready for the tank to be built on top of it. The plan in today's video is to get this entire stand completely finished. And really good idea of what this will look like once we get that done. I'm using 2x10s to build the top support system for the 1100 gallon or 1077 gallon aquarium that I'm going to build by concrete blocks. On top of it, I'm going to be putting sheets of 3/4 inch plywood. These pieces are the width of the tank and only 24 inches wide. I did have to cut them to make sure that they fit. But the reason we're using these is because a plywood aquarium doesn't really have the structure underneath of it to hold itself up. Although I'm going to build it so that this tank is going to be darn near bulletproof. And under each board, I'm going to have a 2x10 here, here, and here. Basically every 8 inches. And now that I know where the boards are gonna go, I cut up some 2x10s to build the basic frame of the top support system. No different than how I showed you how to build countless other aquarium stands. I did this because the plywood aquarium is sort of like an acrylic aquarium where it needs to be supported in the center. And instead of using countless blocks, I kind of wanted to do this to get a little bit of extra height plus guaranteed support. I've never built a plywood aquarium that was over, let's say, 6 feet long. I built 10-foot long aquariums out of glass or out of concrete, and 8-foot long tanks made out of acrylic, 6-foot long tanks made out of glass, etc., but never this long, and I'm worried about it not being flat and true. And then every 8 inches, it's supported underneath. Literally every 8 inches. I've never built a stronger stand. The concrete blocks themselves are separated every 14 inches to every 20 inches, depending on where an electrical receptacle is. And I bet you one's right there, yeah. So this one had to go over this way just a little bit. So I'm not gonna block off any electrical because I want this right up against the wall. And it matches up perfectly with that tank stand over there. Did get some plywood that was on sale, was cheap. And I did that because if I screw the plywood into each end, as well as through the center, it adds an astronomical amount of strength as opposed to just putting the tank down on top of the 2x10s that are simply screwed in. If I did that, all the weight and all the pressure is simply on like 6 screws on each side. One thing I underestimated was the weight of this. Moving this 16-foot long stand around by myself was not easy, but I was able to accomplish it and just do it kind of slowly. I'm a little worried about how I'm going to build the 16-foot long tank because I'm building it as one piece as well. And the way I build plywood aquariums is typically from the bottom up, flip them on their front, insert the viewing panel, flip them back over. I don't think I'm going to have the strength, and or I don't think, even if there was 4 people doing it, I just don't think it's safe to keep moving the plywood tank and flipping it around. Just in case a twist happens in the seam, it could cause some form of leak in the future. So building this is certainly going to be a challenge, but that's a huge reason why I wanted to build it, was I've never built anything like this, and I wanted to challenge myself again. Because it's been a long time since I built something that I've never done. So it's been a relatively busy week. We got the stand done, we got the mock-up tank done. And today, something came that I've been waiting for months. I shouldn't even show you this, but I'm going to. It's for the 2,000 gallon aquarium, and I'm gonna meet you guys in the middle with that one. So all of these came today. These are from Aqua Decor, and it's just for the 2,000 gallon tank. And from what I'm told, it's technically not what I asked for, it's something a little more. So when I unbox it, it's technically gonna be the first time I ever saw it, but it's for the new scape for the 2,000 gallon. The 2,000 gallon aquarium, where I'm going to meet you in the middle, is simple. We're going to scape the tank. You guys love it when it's scaped. I don't, so I'm choosing the scape. I'm going to do something that I saw it and I knew I had to have it. It's going to be Asian arowana friendly and stingray friendly. I'm also turning the 2000, and your guys' favorite rendition of the 2000 was when it was a community aquarium, meaning we had fish from every continent almost in there, and I got to admit, it was technically pretty amazing. I have some fish you guys have not seen and or know about that have been in the gallery for months now, hiding, put away. They're for the 2000. There's other fish that you know about that you will not believe that they're going in the 2000, but I think it's meant to be, and they should. Anyways, if you want to see any of those videos, completing the 2,000 gallon aquarium, completing the 2,000 gallon aquarium again, or building the 16 foot long tank, make sure you're subscribed if you're not already. This is going to be a tremendous amount of work. Thankfully, it's no longer snowing here in Canada, so that's a big thing that slowed this down as well, is all of my tools have to be used outside because, well, I filled this building with aquariums and I don't have any more sheds to build in, so it's got to be done out on the deck and in 3-4 feet of snow. That's virtually impossible and unsafe. Not that I'm ever safe when I'm working with tools. Oh yeah, and planning this year's biggest charity event, arguably the hobby's largest charity event of all time and the only type of its kind. If you haven't heard about it, there's some whispers here and there. Follow me on Instagram if want to see me running around with my shirt off. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed the video. I'll see you in the next one.